the video, leave me your guesses down below. If you guess correctly, you get absolutely nothing except the joy of guessing it correctly.
Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to today's video where I'm going to chat about eyeshadow palettes. And I am going to talk about the eyeshadow palettes that I would keep if I could only keep one eyeshadow palette from a brand. Yes, and if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 46 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. If you want to hear about brands that no one else is talking about, if you want to be inspired by unusual color combinations, and if you are slightly orcish like me, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, because we are having a blast here on the internet. Let me explain the slightly orcish. It means green. I'm a greenie. Yes. Rock on. So my criteria was I need to have three or more palettes. Because if I just have one palette from a brand, then that's the one I'm going to keep. How did I basically pick the palettes? Most of the time I picked the palettes that when I had all the palettes laid out in front of me and I had them all open, I was like, which one brings me the most joy? That is what I did most of the time. Yes, yes. Okay, let's just get into it. Now I do have to explain Makeup Revolution, because Makeup Revolution I split up between Makeup Revolution, which I have currently four palettes from. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, four palettes, and Makeup Obsession, because Makeup Obsession and Makeup Revolution are two separate brands. For Makeup Obsession, I have currently three palettes left, and I pulled the one that I would want to keep from that, and that's the one that's always on top of the pile as well. I don't use it often, but it's this one, the Feeling Spicy. This just makes me warm and fuzzy inside. It doesn't, but it gives me that warm and toasty feeling. So this is a palette that I almost never grab for, but it just gives me a certain feeling that I want to keep this one from the palettes that I have from Makeup Obsession. Here's the color story. This one looks purple, but it is actually not really a purple. It is a brown. Maybe it's a, is it a taupe? Could be. And then if you see it with the orange, that it turns a little bit purple. It was not as purple as I thought it would be. But I do really, I don't know. I opened this palette up as well just to look at the color story. So this just makes me happy. And out of the palettes, the three palettes that I have left for Makeup Obsession, if I can only keep one, it's going to be this one. The next palette that I pulled from Makeup Revolution, it's not necessarily my most favorite palette. It's not the palette that I use the most, but it is the palette that when I had them all open, I was like, if I can only keep one palette out of everything that I have left, this is the palette that I would want to keep because I can do the most with it. And that's the collaboration with Sof, the bigger palette. So what is this? Extreme Spice? Super Spice. This is the color story. The quality is nice enough. It's not my favorite Makeup Revolution quality, because that one is actually the Batman and the Joker palette from their first DC comic. They're basically their smaller square. Are there 9-pen palettes? Yeah, they're 9-pen palettes. I think that that quality is very, very nice. I prefer that quality over this one. But I like the color story of this. I can do a little bit more with this. And let's face it, the other ones, color story wise, one is basically a neutral with a yellow and the other one is also colorful, but I just can do more with this. The shimmers in here are pretty and the quality is nice enough. So that is why I am then keeping that one. The next one that I have here is from BH Cosmetics. I have a bunch of BH Cosmetics palettes left. I opened them all up. Initially I had another palette pulled because the quality blew me away, but honestly, when I had them all open, this was the palette that basically jumped out at me. Yeah, and it's the Optimistic AF, so it's... What can I say? I love this color story so, so much. So every time that I see this, this palette just makes me extremely happy to look at. I love the quality. I love the color story as well. So this one won. The next one is from Colourpop. This is not my favorite Colourpop palette. Let me rephrase. It's not the palette from Colourpop that I use the most. I honestly hardly use it ever. But you cannot get it anymore. So that's why I'm picking this one. And it's the first Hocus Pocus palette. This one, if the rest I can repurchase. But this one I cannot because it's not in stock anymore. I don't know if they will bring it back for round three. But this palette, it just needs to stay. It will stay with me because it's just, what can I say? And I really do like the color story as well. Now actually more because I'm vibing a little bit more with the color story. Especially that part there. But yeah, this is the one that I would keep. For obvious reasons. The next one is from Sigil. And Sigil, I have a bunch of her palettes. I am waiting for one palette as I'm filming this. I am pre-filming. I don't know exactly when this video will go online. But the palette that I'm waiting for is the Peacock palette. That has been in stuck in customs in my country for a month. But out of all the egg palettes that I have from her, the reason that I pulled this particular one is because it is my favorite blue palette. So that's why I picked the Ice Fish. I don't want to get rid of any. And unfortunately, I cannot repurchase most. But this is just, it's my only... It's my favorite blue palette. And the rest of the palettes that I have, I can kind of, maybe-ish, dupe out a little bit. So let's go then to a palette that I have here from Unique Beauty. It's such a unique color story. And honestly, Unique Beauty, she's called Unique Beauty for a reason. Because she does extremely interesting color stories. And the color story, the palettes that I have from her, especially the ones that are next to me that I can grab often, are all a very, very interesting and gorgeous color story. But the one that I pulled to keep, I picked this one because I love the aesthetic. I love the way that it looks. And then the inside, the color story. It's a little bit more blue than the Chinchilla palette is. The Chinchilla is a hint more pink, but you can get a similar vibe. And the shade Doulahan. Can we just... Can you see that? Oh, so you can see it like that, the shift. It's stunning. It's stunning. So that is why this one is staying. Oh, I almost forgot to mention. I have codes with a few of the brands. I have one. They will all be listed down below. And I will list. If I have a code with a brand, I will put it fancily in the screen. Like a good YouTuber. Yes. Okay. The next brand I'm going to mention is Nomad. And from Nomad, it was almost a nightmare. I had a few palettes open and I was like, I don't want to lose any. This will come as a surprise for most of you. I think at least the palette that I picked. But this palette, it's just, there is just something about this particular palette. That if I could only keep one palette from Nomad right now, this was the one that has to stay. The rest I would repurchase. Yes, even though most I got in PR, but still I would repurchase. But this one, it's just... It's the entire vibe. It's something that I also grab for a lot. And it's the Malibu Quad from Nomad. There is just something about this. This feeling. Happy vibes. What can I say? And then the color story. This is, especially if you're an olive, perfect neutral palette. You know? For most people, it's a brown that's a neutral, but for us greenies, it's more this. This palette, it's just so easy. This shade, it's not a satin, but it's almost a satin. This one has a hint more shine. I can use this as a brow powder, and I have. I use this to just do a very, very quick and easy look. It's just, when I open this up, there's just something about what this palette does. The color story, the vibe, it relaxes me. I don't know, it's just, this is the one that just Malibu Surf Shack. I don't know, I want to have a Malibu Surf Shack, you know, but in these colors. I love that color. See, I love that color. It's, yeah, that's the palette that has to stay for me. Yeah. The next brand I am going to go to is Saint Angel Sinners. Now I have a bunch of her palettes. I pulled the palette that I would want. This palette just, it's not a palette from her that I use the most, but it's a palette that it just intrigues me so, so much. And it is her Over the Moon palette. So this is the outside. And then here is the inside. And I love her six pan palettes. This color story, it just, the only thing, and I have said that before, the only thing I wish is that this one was more brown instead of red. For me being an olive, the red pops a little bit more. But if I want to deepen up this green, I cannot really use this shade for that. Because I don't know, it just makes it, this shade for me, it's a little bit too red. And it makes it muddy if I want to deepen up the green. That's the only thing. But still, this is what I would keep. Because it's just so extremely intriguing to me. And yeah. Quality. Chef's kiss. Okay, let's go to another one of my favorite. No, let's kind of do it like this. Let's go to another drugstore brand. Let's go to Catrice. From Catrice, I have a bunch of palettes. And I was kind of like, is this the one that I'm going to want to keep? And I was like, yeah. Yeah, yes I am. And the rest I will just repurchase. Not everything, but most of it is. I chose the Pro Slim Mint to Be palette, or Hint of Mint palette. I did 3 looks with this palette, and it's just such a cute palette. This also makes me very, very happy with the minty shades. And honestly, the other ones that I was thinking about, with the exception of the Vintage Soul, I have it also strewn about in other palettes that I have. But there's just something with that minty, that especially now, I need that minty in my life. So, and I really did like the quality of this a lot. So that's why this one is staying. This one is, as far as I know, right now only available in Europe. It is available at Cosmetic for Less. But I don't know if Cosmetic for Less ships to the USA. They do ship internationally, and I will link it down below. The next one that I'm going to mention is Lethal Cosmetics. And I also have a bunch of Lethal's palettes. The palette that I picked, it's the formula I love a lot. Lethal usually has a pretty soft formula. This formula for me has a little bit more substance almost. I feel that the colors in here, the colorful shadows in here, are a bit more rich than they usually have. And I love the formula, but I loved the complete vibe of this. So this is also, it's the Berlin. Berlin 89. 89 was when the wall came down. It's not that long ago. I watched it on TV live. The way that they did this, the color story and the performance of this is, yeah, this is the one that I would want to keep. And I'm very, very interested to see their newest palette, because I really want to compare it also to the formula that's in here. Personally, I love their old formula as well, but I love this one a little bit more. So I'm kind of hoping it's a little bit more towards this one. I know that they changed the formula, so I hope it's more towards this one than their other ones. But we will see when I get it. But yeah, that one, it's just everything. It's everything. The next palette that I'm going to go, or the next brand I'm going to go to, is Kaleido. So the palette that I picked, this is a palette also. It just, it's stunning. It's unique. It makes me happy. It's the flower punk. The way that they did this, the way that it looks, and that you can just, you know, open this up, you can at least, you can, it's a tiny Barbie mirror, you know? And then here's the color story. And I just love this. I just love how they did this. And this just makes me happy to look at. I can hear you saying, why didn't you choose the Club Nebula palette? I have my reasons, and we will get to that in a minute. The next one that I'm going to go to is Juvia's Place. And from Juvia's Place, I have decluttered a bunch of Juvia's Place, but the one that I immediately pulled, it's this one. It's the Tribe. And it is the color, it's the outside color, but it's also the color story. I really, 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 really love this color story. I don't play with it enough. Yeah, this shade, oh. And it stays relatively this color on me as well. It's just stunning. So this is definitely one of my favorite palettes also from them that I still have left. And this is the one that every time I think of Juvia's Place, this is the one that creeps up in my mind. So that is why it had to stay. Let's next go to 5050 Makeup. And 5050 Makeup is a Dutch indie brand. One of the first indie brands that I actually started working with. This palette was PR. And when I had them all open, I was choosing between two. And this one won. Yeah, that's it. This one won. And it is the Autumn palette from their season collection. So let me show you the Autumn palette. It's nothing really that special maybe, but still the combination of colors here. This shade Decay, it's one of those. It looks like Decay, you know? So, and then also in combination with this, I love it. So yes, the Autumn palette from 5050 Makeup. Then I am going to go to Glam Shop. And from Glam Shop, yeah, I was choosing between two. This is the one that won. And it's the Zelone palette, which means green. It's slightly orcish. Well, kinda. But yeah, this palette, what can I say? It's four mattes, but the shimmers also in here. And this was actually the very, very first palette that I tried from Glam Shop. Can I swatch that there? It was the very first palette that I tried from Glam Shop and it made me fall in love with the formula. So yeah, this is it's just such a good palette. What can I say? Shimmers are stunning. The mattes are so, so easy to work with. Glam Shop, they're based in Poland. They're a Polish indie brand, actually. They're amazing. And the next brand that I'm going to go to is Unearthly Cosmetics. And the palette that I pulled from her, this, yeah, it makes me happy. It makes me happy. What can I say? It still says Alien Cosmetics on the front here because this is, well, basically before she rebranded. And it's the Strawberry Milkshake palette. This palette just, I think it's cute. And I can use this in so many ways. I can use the pink as a blush. I love the colors that are in here. I love the combination of colors that are in here. And this just makes me want to do a green look with a red bottom. And all that. And pink in the inner corner because I love it. Yeah. And the quality is very, very good. So the next brand I'm going to mention is V Cosmetics. And I have a bunch of her palettes. And they are all equally stunning. But there's just one palette. It was also the first palette that I got from her. There's just one palette that's always on display. This palette does something to me. This is the one that will always stay. If it's going bad, I will depot it and I will still keep it. It's the Vixen. Can we just see? Now this was a collaboration palette. I think it's still available. And then here is the color story, which is also very, very pretty. No glitters in here. I had a lot of fun with this palette. A lot of fun. I did a 5 looks video, but I also used it on multiple occasions. But this is just a palette that I just want to keep forever and ever from her. Yeah. Okay. Next I'm going to go to Beauty Bay. And it's going to be the Wilderness. I'm going to keep the Wilderness. Because it's just, this color story, it just, it's so, so interesting. And it just does something. And I'm so sad that it was a limited edition. And that they did not put this in their permanent lineup. It's staying. What can I say? I think it's also unicorn for a lot of people. I have two brands left. So let's go to Natasha Denona. As I'm filming this, I haven't purchased the pastel palette yet, but I know when you are seeing this, I have. But still, even though thinking, I almost know that I will love the formula, but thinking at what I have from her right now, and also including that color story, there is just a palette that The reason that I pulled this palette is because it's a palette that I have wanted for ages. And I finally have it. I don't think I need to explain why this one stays, right? The gold palette from Natasha Denona. This is just... I have wanted this one for so, so long. And now I have it. And it's just such a nice palette. It's such a nice palette. The green is not my favorite. But the rest, yeah. I really love it. So that is why this one is going to stay. The last palette that I'm going to mention is from Odin's Eye. And maybe you can guess which one it is. Pause the video, leave me your guesses down below. If you guess correctly, you get absolutely nothing except the joy of guessing it correctly. I have a bunch of palettes from Odin's Eye that I would want to repurchase immediately. If I were to lose everything, but this is a palette that I don't want to give up, ever. And that is the Hela palette that they did in collaboration with Angelica Nefis. Now, I was kind of also debating with myself, do I include collaboration palettes or not? Because I kind of did not really want to choose between different collaborators. But because this... So I basically took Angelica actually out of the picture. But because this is Hela, which is one of my favorite goddesses, the way that they have done this, the color story of this, that is ultimately why I kept this. Why I put this one in the video. And it's also the reason that it's not a nebula, because it's this one. And I did not want to put two of her palettes in. So yeah, let me know your thoughts. Were there surprises? And yeah, and you know, I also pulled palettes with the thought process behind them that I could repurchase the ones that I kind of want to keep as well. You know, so that is how I did it. I thought this was a fun video. I think it's fun to go through your collection in a different way. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.